Hello, my name is Jeff Mumm. I'm an associate professor with the Johns Hopkins Wilmer Eye Institute, where we study retinal regeneration. The focus of our lab is essentially to determine how the eye can repair itself. And to do that, we use a small minnow-like zebrafish that has an innate capacity to do that. We like to view that as essentially having an expert on hand in the lab who can teach us exactly how that process works. There are several key advantages to the use of the zebrafish that we try to fully leverage in the lab. The first and foremost, of course, is their capacity to regenerate. We need an expert on hand in order to learn how to apply what we come to realize in the lab toward therapeutic outputs for patients. But the second thing is that they're actually very amenable to allowing us a direct window into how things happen in the eye. They're highly transparent, and that allows us to essentially make movies of how the cells in the eye accomplish the task of replacing lost cells. We get an insight into who the stem cells are, who the different cell types who impinge upon the stem cells' ability to repair the eye are, and it's essentially then the molecular and cellular mechanisms at the heart of maybe tapping into our own dormant capacity for self-repair. Another key advantage of the zebrafish is that they're really small, at least at the larval stage, and that helps because it allows us to pursue big science. By that, I mean we can actually create inducible disease models that allow us to then interrogate tens of thousands of organisms a day with respect to, say, drug discovery, and to try to define compounds that stimulate the fish's ability to regenerate its eye. By analogy, then, we would hope that those compounds could then be turned around and used in humans to stimulate our capacity to repair as well. It's really been great working here at Hopkins. It's a highly collaborative environment, and that's really helped to push our research forward toward not only the basic insights that we try to derive in the lab, but actually then the eventual translation of those insights back out into the clinic for human patients.